to set up a multinational industry in Naivasha is history ajaba, to create microchips. Nimeongelea tu microchips hai. Na hii microchip, you need Coltan to do it. Why are they doing it in Naivasha? We all know about radioactive emissions and all that. One funny thing about the United States of America, vitu sensitive kama hizi, they don't do them in their land. Huo wanazifanya inje, in other country. Because of any dangerous emissions, ni sisi sasa ndio tutaumia. Hii microchips need coltan. The reason why USA want wanafanya hivi, first of all, they want land cheaply and unopposed. The only way they are going to be unopposed is when they take the supremo of that country in their pocket. Who is the supremo in Kenya? William Samoei Ruto. They want land cheaply and unopposed. So they want to produce microchip due to the tension between Chinese and Taiwan. The tension between Chinese and Taiwan wanataka. So ile propaganda walitumia during the World War, unajua one of the reasons why USA merged as superpowers ni propaganda. Kutupa nuclear followed by propaganda. That is hii pia sasa wanakuja na microchip due to tension between Chinese and Taiwan. And in Kenya, all the things that I have mentioned, those are Western multinational corporations. And our mineral souls, instead of feeding Kenyans, mulisikia, we are talking about 970 of them. Instead of feeding, hiyo ni mingi. Kama coltan peke, kama min niobium peke yake ndio tunaongelea $62.4 billion. That is just niobium in Mrima Hills. Nataka mfanye just a small edit mahali huko, hesabu rahisi haraka haraka, hesabu rahisi, we go. Mrima Hills niobium at the current status quo, $62.4 billion. Mnakumbuka nikiwaambia ya kwamba China Geological Exploration Technology Institute walifanya surveillance raw data on Kenya's mineral wealth, na wakasema their research saizi inaonyesha that Kenya can earn up to $140.6 billion from the sector kwa coastal area peke yake. Ongezeni hapo, tutumie tu hizo mbili, hiyo ni pesa ngapi? We are talking about billions of dollars. Hiyo ni pesa ngapi? Tujaguza Northern. We've not touched the gold in Nyanza. Kisii has stupendously numerous gold. And while I'm finishing, nitawasomia areas mali kuna mineral souls in this country, like serious mineral souls, which has not been published because I got a very confidential document ya Gava. So, I did another surveillance. Before ni toke hapo, wacha ni expose. Safaricom is actually one of the people who are feeding from the Western multinational corporations. Safaricom yenye mnaona. Ndiyo maana mkiona Safaricom wanazimia watu data. Safaricom wanazimia watu data. People are being massacred in Rongai. What best can you get from them? Safaricom is one of the people. Nili mention Safaricom. Nili mention some banks. I mentioned IBM. I mentioned a lot of them. And Safaricom is actually one of them. Wakati unaona wanalipa CEO au 360 million per month, unafikiri hiyo pesa inakuja tu hivi hivi? They have money and they are one of the people who are benefiting from Western multinational corporations. Hii Safaricom yetu. Let me read something here. Broadly, the physiographical features of Kenya, mali kuna mineral souls. Nitaenda tu haraka haraka because iko mingi. Shimba in the Kwale Hills. Kwale tumongelea hapa mara ngapi? Mesozoic sediments. We are talking about narrow coastal plain in the southeast, which broadens into a wide embayment north of River Sabaki. A discontinuous chain of hills made up of mesozoic sediments. Kwale Hills, that one I've talked about. The Nyika, I think we all know about the Nyika. Hizi plateaus mnaona hapa, hata zingine wa man-made. Some of these things, by the way, topography is, when we geologists will help us here, topography zingine zinakuja as natural na zingine zinakuja as zimekuwa made. Ndio maana unapata kuna certain type of topography in a certain place. Umesikia man-made hills. So mpaka Nyika has been mentioned here. Coastal hills zote, let me just summarize this. Coastal hills zote ziko na mineral souls. The western edge of the Nyika is bounded by extensive hills, iko na mineral souls. Basement system rocks. Mali unaona rocks. ujue hapo kuna stupendously numerous mineral salts. The west of this broad belt stretching from the region of Lake Magadi. Kuna jamaa alimention Lake Magadi hapa. I think mnaweza kumbuka. Ndio hapa we are talking about gold. And that person was actually true. It's being confirmed. And there's a very confidential report yenye gava imeficha. Lake Magadi, we are now here talking about gold. Where is that? To Lake Rudolph. Of tertiary to recent volcanic rocks. We are talking about this. We are talking about the Rift Valley Belt. The whole of Rift Valley Belts. And the person who was telling me Maimayo has no mineral salt. Maimayo is the inlet of Nairobi County. The door of Nairobi County from the Rift Valley is Maimayo. Very precious, extremely precious. And the western side of Nakuru. Extremely precious and has a lot of mineral salts because of the alluvium deposits that come with gold, copper, and all the other mineral salts that it normally carries. I've talked about the Rift Valley Belt. So wale ambao wanaishi Rift Valley, and that one will now bring us to West Pokot. What happens in West Pokot? The west of the islands, constantly mainly of the Peneplian, rising to the east from 4,000 to about 5,000 feet, underlain by Precambrian rocks invaded by granites. Na hii ni research ilianza kufanywa kitambo sana. The westernmost part of Kenya, Lake Victoria. And when we tell you Lake Victoria has gold, it is serious. Lake Victoria has gold with a few of